Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS with a quick update on my Lego city. And unfortunately, there's just not much to see that's new. There's not a whole lot that has gone on here. I'm at a state where I need to do a little bit more planning on the computer to kind of adjust the arrangement of where everything is going to be, because I've made some changes in my plans just a little bit. Haven't made any new structures since the last update, I don't think. Just some vehicles and mocks that either you have seen already or you will see soon in independent videos, so those will be put up separately. Started putting in just a little bit of detail on the park section over here by the side. This is going to be an area where I've talked about this on the blog before, but I'll say it again, is this is going to be an area where things will change out on a somewhat regular basis. We'll have different themes and different types of exhibits and things that'll come to the park. So it looks like the first exhibit or first theme or event at the park is going to be dinosaurs at the park, even though this right here is technically not a dinosaur, but we're going to have some of those just up there just for kids, you know, fake ones, of course. They're just going to be sculptures, statues, maybe animatronic, maybe not. But this is just putting a little bit more detail into what's going to be happening with the park. I'm starting to define where the playground area is going to be. That may need to be a little bit larger. Going to have a nice little gazebo kind of area over here. Folks can have weddings, outdoor weddings there and stuff. Over here, getting closer to the shore, started putting in just a little bit of detail for the shoreline area with a little bit of sand there and some foliage. Nothing here is permanent at this point, and that's going to continue to be the case for a long time. Nothing is going to be permanent. However, here's one really good thing that came out of stuff that I recently changed up. The water section of the city along here, along the shore, has been increased in size. So I've increased it back here and moved in a whole other two new base plates worth of water. So that's going to give me a lot more room for open water space and also more room for my little harbor. And by putting in this turn right here, this curved piece of base plate, that's giving me more room in here to put kind of my marina and also the office for the park section. And then a lot of that kind of reshaping is going in conjunction with my decision to put the zoo section over here. So that's where that's going to be. What animals are going to be in there is not finalized at all, but it's going to have two major sections to it. One will be with land and air animals, which will be on this side, and then there's going to be a second side which will have a kind of an aquarium exhibit, and there will be an underwater section. That'll be really, really great for me because I haven't had an aquarium type of layout in Lego form since 2001 when I did my original Lego city that I did. Which is pictures of that on my blog, or pictures of that on my Flickr account and also on my personal website, I think. Might need to go back and repost those again, but I had an aquarium display on my original Lego city from back then that I really liked and I really miss. So now I'll be able to recreate that using some newer stuff and some newer techniques and have a whole underwater scene that you'll be able to look at. So that'll be really good. One thing that changes as a result of that, in addition to kind of moving things around in this corner, I was going to put my residential area, my residential neighborhood, coming right down to here and going up the side along that side on the train track side over there. Maybe a little bit here in this corner a little bit, but not so much, mostly down here. And obviously I'm not going to do that now. So my residential area is going to go on the opposite side of the city. It's going to go all the way back there against that wall along that corner. It's going to be something a little bit different in that corner, but most of the residential units will be back along there. It will be, you know, a road going through there, and that'll kind of be the transition area between city and suburban neighborhood. And other than that, nothing else new. So a lot of planning, a lot of thoughts, but I've kind of been stuck in review mode for a while now. So many products to review and making sure that I'm putting out enough content to keep everybody content. Like I said, there are some mocks here that you probably haven't seen just yet, but I will be putting up videos on those pretty soon. So stay tuned to the blog at jangbricks.com if you want to see everything as quickly as possible, as soon as it comes out, oftentimes before it shows up on YouTube. And a lot of the time, stuff will show up only at jangbricks.com because there will be absolutely no need to make videos for them. Not everything warrants an actual video. So stay tuned for more. Thank you very much for watching. And like I said, sorry there's not more to see at this time, but I'll get to the point where I've got enough reviews done for a while that I'll be able to spend more time just making custom stuff, and especially structures like buildings and houses and stuff. Really looking forward to that. So I'll talk to you guys again soon. Bye for now.